Let's take a walk outside, just you and me for an 1 foot ride.
What was going through my mind was, oh my God, I can't believe that the baby Carol Chung is getting married and is going to be a full-fledged woman and starting phase three of her life. I consider college phase two. So it's like starting her life with Steve, and you know, then she's going to have kids soon. And then it was good to see the chemistry that exists between the both of them and just how serious but light everything is at the same time. I think that was beautiful to watch.
I'm Lagaya. For those of you that don't know me, I attended college with Carol, and I was fortunate enough to snag her into a friendship for many, many years. Carol and I met over a decade ago. She had this beloved red Supra. So Carol and I used to ride around, and she was like really hardcore driving around in her car. And I was actually really struck by her because not only was she this fast-driving, really smart, sharp gal, but she introduced me to lots of new things in my life, like new wave music of the 80s, which was a big deal. And we actually ended up going out one night. We packed 10 people into her Supra, and I knew that we were going to be friends forever.
Steven has always been an awesome brother. He has always been a lot of fun. And we spent a lot of time growing up with each other and playing in the creek and just making forts. And we've always had a close relationship. He's just a lot of fun to be with, always makes me laugh and just makes me feel very cared for. He's just an awesome brother. And I'm really happy for him and Carol. They work well together because they both have common interests and they both have common careers, and they both love animals, and they're both just really good-hearted, loving, caring people. They're just both just lovely, lovely people.
What's so remarkable about Carol is that she is not only really fun-loving and really sweet, but she's also very unique. She is extremely artistic, I think, much like the rest of her family. She also had this very, you know, sort of quiet, deep strength about her that I always admired. And I remember when she met Steve, she was like, I met this guy, Steve, and you know, he keeps asking me to do things with me, and I can't figure out, you know, what the deal is. And I was like, okay, well, send me a link to this guy. And from like one look at his MySpace profile, I was like, this is the guy for you.
Hi.
I had a good idea that he was going to marry Carol just because I could see by the way that they looked at each other, and they're just so natural around each other, and when they're talking, and they just always seem to have such a good time when they're with each other, and you can tell that they really love each other.
They kept in touch through the years. 2 years it took him to charm her. And I think, you know, Steve has this sort of unique blend of characteristics as well. Like underneath all of those impeccable suits, there's a tattooed punk loving hardcore music lover, and you know, I think when you think about somebody as unique as Carol that has all of these hidden talents and all of these you know, kind of diverse interests, it takes a really special person to crack that nut, and Steve definitely did.
I knew Carol actually was going to end up with Steve a long time ago. I just knew that, you know, those two were going to end up together. And it was funny because when Steve went around and was asking for Carol's hand, he then came to me and he's like, so I made all the rounds to Carol's mom and brothers that I'm going to ask her to marry me. And he also sort of like, you know, like sort of asked me in a way. And it was very cute, I thought. You know, it was like I was Carol's guardian in a way. So I love that.
I definitely knew that he would ask Carol. He just enjoyed her, and you could just see it in his eyes, you could see it in her eyes, and you could see the connectiveness that they had and the love that they shared for one another.
'Cause I am on your side. And you're
finding each other and just, you know, uniting a marriage. It's amazing to see that. I couldn't believe it. I still can't. It's just hard to believe that my little brother got married today.
For those of you who don't know me, I'm Steve's little brother, Chris, and I'm extremely honored to be here tonight as the best man for not only my brother, but my best friend. Being Steve's little brother wasn't always so easy. There's a time when I was 5 when he told me the house was being robbed and I had to hide in my bedroom for hours just so he could get rid of me. There's all the time spent waiting in the bathroom as Steve put his hair together. Or there's a tricky place where he pulls a car away from you just about as you get to go ahead in. He actually still does that. Something he learned from the Wonder Years. Steve's quite the prankster. When I first met Carol, I knew Steve met his match. Carol's sweet, caring, and funny, but when Steve gets out of line, she's quick to send him a man dressed in a pink gorilla suit to Steve's office to sing to him, "You Are My Sunshine." Marriage is not about finding a person you can live with. It's about finding a person you can't live without. Steve found that person. Here's to a lifetime of happiness and love for Carol and Steve.
It's very hard not to think about my dad at this time, because I know that he would have wanted to see this moment and watch his baby girl become a woman and get married today. So I think that for all of us, that was a difficult thought, but we know that wherever he is watching over Carol. He's very happy as well.
Mr. and Mrs. Stephen Reed.
I've been able to see this really marked shift in Carol. She actually moved out of her high-rise apartments in New York and moved into a brownstone with Steve, and I know he definitely grounds her. And it's funny, when I stayed with Carol and Steve the first time, they were the first people to introduce me to grocery delivery. So not only do they understand, you know, going out and exploring things together, but they also know how to unwind and chill out together, which is the makings of a great relationship. And now they've got a wonderful family. They've got Hamilton and Clover, their dog and cat, and I think they're almost complete. But they really do sort of complement each other very, very well. Steve is a very kind and thoughtful guy, and I think Carol has definitely found her match. So I wanted to leave you with a quote from Lao Tzu. To love someone deeply gives you strength. Being loved by someone deeply gives you courage. To Carol and Steve, may you cherish each other and really join together in happiness with this union. Ladies and gentlemen, to the couple. Cheers.
Thank you.
You know, if you look at the people who have come to the party and just how everybody has meshed together, it represents, you know, the future, I think. You know, it's all the building blocks of family, good friends, and it's an intimate party. And I think these are all the building blocks for their future.
It's so great to be here to celebrate Carol and Steve's wedding. My brother Dan and I got to know Steve's brother and best man Chris and Steve's best friends recently in Vegas for his bachelor party. Dan and I were trying to figure out afterward if these nice guys were really that well behaved or if it was just because the brides, you know, brides and brothers were there. We're pretty sure it's because they're just really nice guys. This weekend we've also gotten to know Steve's wonderful parents, Kathy and Jim, and sister Laura too. So it occurs to me that while you're all here, this might be the perfect opportunity to tell the Reed family a couple of things about Carol that they may not already know. You guys may not know, for example, that as on top of things Carol is these days, there was a time when her all-time favorite hobby was pretty much sleeping. I mean, like, anytime, anywhere, we thought maybe she had narcolepsy. She could literally take a nap in just about every place you could imagine, on the couch, in front of the TV, backseat of a family car, in her closet while trying on clothes. My brother Dan and I would try to do stuff with her, but we couldn't find her half the time. We'd call out her name, searching around the house. My friends would come over and think that the cat had gone missing. Well, it was probably only recently that it dawned on us that maybe she was only pretending to be asleep all those times. Okay, so I guess it wasn't always easy growing up with two competitive older brothers, but Carol, we just really wanted to do fun and cool stuff with you, like, you know, coach you on how to maximize your GPA, see how many digits of pi you could memorize, or the most fun of all, teaching you how to crack an SAT. It didn't matter that you were only 9, you know, you gotta get started early in these things.
I just wanna wish Carol and Steve the most happiness, and I just want them to know that I love them very much and to have the time of their life and to always remember the good times.
Well, Steve, I must say we're really glad now that Carol made the move back east. Honestly, when Carol first described you to me, I really wasn't sure what to think. She said something like, well, he's super sweet and cool and really into music like you. Oh, and he's got these awesome tattoos and very distinguished silver hair. I was preparing myself to meet a 50-something burnt-out rocker dude on a Harley. But it's clear to us all what a talented, smart, and good-hearted person you are. And I've seen time and again with my own eyes the tenderness, respect, and kindness that you always show Carol. And I am truly delighted tonight to welcome you to our family. And I can't wait to teach your kids how to crack the SAT too. To Carol and Steve.
It's a beautiful day. Everything is perfect. Everything's perfect. His father and I are very proud.
I was so filled with joy watching my sister get married today, and I'm just so proud of her and so happy.
You are all I want. All I want is you.
I think it was seeing them together in front of the ceremony. You know, I always knew that they loved each other tremendously and they have a lot of respect for each other. But just seeing that interaction there and how natural it was, I thought, you know, this is it. If you know, this is how a union should begin. And that's how it is. That moment I saw, it was just wow.
Hi, Stephen. Take you, Carol.
Hi, Carol. Take you, Stephen.
To be my wife.
To be my husband.
I promise to be true to you.
Through whatever life presents us. I promise to honor our dreams, to provide comfort and peace in our home.
I will love, honor, and respect you all the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
I'm so happy. How could this be? The one in my dreams is right beside me. I pray this.
Gift of the earth, crafted into rings to be worn as a sign of the bond of love between this couple. Stephen, please repeat after me. Carol, the this ring symbolizes?
Carol, this ring symbolizes
the unending union.
The unending union
of my life with yours.
Of my life with yours.
Your dreams are now my dreams.
Your dreams are now my dreams.
Your hopes are my hopes.
Your hopes are my hopes.
Your love is my blessing.
Your love is my blessing.
Carol, please repeat after me. Stephen, this ring symbolizes.
Stephen, this ring symbolizes
the unending union.
The unending union
of my life with yours.
Of my life with yours.
Your dreams are now my dreams.
Your dreams are now my dreams.
Your hopes are my hopes.
Your hopes are my hopes.
Your love is my blessing.
Your love is my blessing.
Carol and Stephen, in each other, you have found home. You have fallen in love and nurtured your relationship so that it will last a lifetime. You have joined your hands and hearts and sealed them with vows and rings. And so it shall be from this day forward. Before these witnesses, it is with great joy and happiness that I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may now share your first kiss.
Carol asked me to keep it clean. This was 10 minutes. Now it's just 60 seconds.
Suck it in.
Guys, just get in there, right? Don't be shy.
Oh, wow.
There might be a dollar bill down there, too. Oh, I also put my phone down there and the keys to the car.
Yeah, exactly.
You guys are so cute. Did you pick that out yourself?
Yeah.
I can tell.
How many flowers are there?
They're both good.
Five?
And now this young man here, whom I have no doubt will make you very happy. Not here. But, oh, there you are. Okay. I'm going to do my De Niro thing.
Each other directly, you know, feel a little playful.
I was preparing myself to meet a 50-something burnt-out rocker dude on a Harley. Oh wait, no, that's his friend Joey over there. I'm just kidding.
Mom said I should walk in with a rolling pin.
Yeah.
Like, ready to swing it at
someone. If you're up for it, we're up for it, dude.
And
we don't get to
run a ball and chain. Ball and chain is good.
Oh, I got one too.
Oh, wow. That's great.